four officers just royally enraged anti-cop NFL with what they suddenly walked out on field and said. The ongoing national anthem protest in the National Football League has received widespread backlash and media attention. Vice President Pence even walked out of a game when it happened. While the players of the game have decided to disrespect the flag, the watchers and those who partake in watching this pastime have shown their patriotism. However, unlike the National Football League, the Major League Baseball showed the respect they have for veterans and their country during Game 7 of the World Series. The league invited police officers to sing the national anthem in honor of law enforcement officers. They were members of the Los Angeles Police Department. In perfect harmony, four officers sang the national anthem. Those officers were Tim Talman, Ray Morales, Michelle Ardis, and Ross Curry. Many took to social media in response to express their support. All the players from both teams stood for the anthem regardless of race, color, or creed. During the seventh inning stretch of the initial World Series game, the league played the song God Bless America, something which is not ordinarily done. It was sung by a group of military veterans who were located inside the stadium. The conservative Tribune reported. Amazingly, fragile liberals had a problem with this song, as well. It looks like anything vaguely traditional or pro-America is offensive to the far left. Ooh, they replaced seventh inning stretch Take Me Out to the Ball Game with God Bless America. The American jingoism is unbearable, comma wrote one Twitter user. Yeah. Freedom and patriotism. Like, ooh. There is no reason for God Bless America at the ballpark. You don't have to take off your hat. You don't even have to stand, comma posted journalist Charles P. Pierce. God Bless America has in fact been played during many MLB games since the 9/11 terrorist attacks, and of course has a much older history, as well. It was actually a favorite of Franklin D. Roosevelt, a Democrat, and was used as his official campaign song. Even though the Tear Down Everything crowd doesn't like it, however, Major League Baseball seems to understand who its true fans are, red-blooded Americans who believe in values like liberty, respecting the military and standing with the thin blue line. It looks like baseball really is America's sport. If the NFL knew what was good for them, they would follow in the MLB's footsteps, because the ratings for the MLB have been exploding while the ratings of the NFL have floundered as a result of these ridiculous protests. The 10-inning Game 5 of the World Series drew in 12.8 million people on Fox, while the Steelers vs. Lions game only drew a meager 9.4 million people. It hasn't been since 2003 since the MLB has gotten ratings that are this good. While NFL ratings are going down. But that does not seem to change anything, because NFL players are continuing their kneeling protests during the national anthem. The Conservative Tribune reported. While it is easy to see why the players would be offended by such a remark, a protest during the national anthem isn't exactly the best way to express their discontent with McNair. In fact, such a display only angers football fans more, especially when there are many more constructive, respectful ways in which these players could voice their concern over the oppressed in this country. Why don't these men actually offer to help the oppressed in some way other than take a knee? The gesture drew criticism for another reason, as it seemed to indicate that players are now just looking for a reason, any reason to protest. While the NFL has continued these protests, the MLB has stayed out of the fray and refused to partake in it or comment on it. Even though amateur and professional sportsmen and women have included themselves in it. While it is unknown why they have chosen not to protest, the obvious conclusion would be that they are aware their viewers are conservative and they too would lose ratings if they chose to partake in it. Or the obvious, it is simply the right thing to do to stand for the national anthem. Considering what happened to MLB players who protested, it's no wonder they all stood. Just look at what the New York Post reported. Police say Oakland Athletics catcher Bruce Maxwell showed signs of intoxication when he was arrested following accusations that he pointed a handgun at the head of a woman in Scottsdale who had delivered food to his home. Court records released Monday provide more details on his arrest, but don't offer an explanation for why he allegedly pointed the gun at the driver. Scottsdale police declined to comment on what prompted Maxwell to allegedly answer the door with a gun on Saturday evening. The documents show Maxwell denied pointing a gun at the driver. The court documents say once the driver explained why she was there, Maxwell lowered the gun. The driver became frightened, handed the food over to Maxwell at the doorstep and left. When officers arrived there, they say Maxwell had alcohol on his breath, showed signs of intoxication, often yelled during the police encounter and made anti-police statements. Maxwell was booked on suspicion of aggravated assault with a deadly weapon and disorderly conduct. He was released Sunday night on a $10,000 bond. Maxwell's attorney, Michael Kimmerer, said during an initial court appearance that his client has never really had any kind of criminal activity before in his life. The AS have previously said the team was disappointed by the allegations and is taking the investigation seriously.